Today, the truth behind if BCAAs are worth it or a waste of your money. Hey, this is Colin DeWay. If you want to master your metabolism and create forever results, start now by subscribing and click on that bell notification so you don't miss anything. So in the last year or two, it seems like the fitness science community has kind of come down pretty hard on BCAAs. Many going as far as to say it's a complete waste of your money. In fact, there was a couple reviews done by highly respected people in the community, one being by Robert Wolf and the other Brad Schoenfeld was involved in. And what came from them was basically that if protein was high enough, BCAAs don't have a muscle building effect. Many people took this and ran with it, saying that BCAAs were a complete waste of money and all you have to do is hit your protein, but I don't necessarily think that's fair, and I think we need to look a little bit deeper as to what BCAAs can do for us. Now, I'm certainly not here to argue that BCAAs are the same as protein when it comes to building muscle, but just because they don't necessarily build muscle on their own doesn't mean they don't have other ways of helping. In fact, one thing to keep in mind is if you're in a fat loss phase, unless you're brand new to training, the point of dieting isn't to build muscle, it's to retain the muscle that you already have. And while in order to build muscle, protein synthesis has to be higher than protein breakdown, both sides of the equation are important. So while BCAAs don't necessarily promote anabolism on their own, they can help with reducing muscle protein breakdown. And the less protein breakdown that you have, the more likely you're going to be able to hang on to the muscle that you do build. In fact, one of the things that's very rarely talked about with BCAAs is if you take them in between meals after a protein-containing meal, you can help keep the elevated protein synthesis response from that meal for a longer period of time. You see, there seems to be a refractory period in how long you can increase muscle protein synthesis, and this was shown in a study where they infused amino acids into people for 6 hours straight. And what they saw was protein synthesis elevated significantly in the first 60 minutes and even continued to rise a little bit for the first 2 hours. However, after 2 hours was completed, it came back down to near baseline levels and stayed there even though they continued to infuse the amino acids. So basically what this showed is there's a refractory period where you can no longer continue to increase protein synthesis. But with that being said, there was a study done in rats where they gave leucine about 2 hours after a protein-containing meal, and what they showed was they were able to prolong the amount of time that protein synthesis was elevated by giving a leucine spike in between the meals. Now, the study also showed that you could get the same response from carbs, however, it would equate to needing about 50 grams of carbs in between meals to do this, and the benefit of doing BCAAs over carbs is that there's basically no calories in BCAAs, whereas 50 carbs, especially in a fat loss phase, is going to add up real fast and make it difficult to hit your numbers. Now, if you want to get really technical, BCAAs do technically have calories, it's just an incomplete protein, so labels don't have to claim them as actual calories, but even still, it's only 4 calories per gram, and really, as long as you're doing the same thing every single day, it really is irrelevant anyways, and I don't recommend that people worry about tracking their BCAAs. But anyway, if you can take BCAAs between meals and potentially have the amount of time that your body has elevated protein synthesis, it would only stand to reason that you could potentially see some benefits and some better results by doing so. And hey, science is great. I'm all about looking at data and trying to come up with the best ways to do things, but I also think anecdote matters as well, and I was talking to Paul Ravello about this, and he basically said that he has just noticed that the competitors that take the BCAAs between meals just seem to do better. And if someone like Paul is seeing this in the amount of clients that he has and the caliber of clients that he brings, it's worth taking note. In fact, Paul is coaching me right now through my first prep, and he has me doing it between meals, so I'm definitely doing it myself. Now, that doesn't mean that BCAAs are necessary, and it doesn't mean that they're going to be a great help, but there are some specific examples of times when I do think they are very useful. So keep watching and I'll explain what scenarios they make the most sense with. Not only that, but as a side note, one of the things that I'm just not that good at is getting my water in the way I should. And by taking BCAAs between meals, what I'm doing is I'm mixing it with about 20 ounces of water each time, and it's really helping me get my fluid game up and get the water in that I usually lack. So obviously you don't need BCAAs to get your water in, but it can help, especially if you just don't like drinking water like me. Now, as far as the specific scenarios where I think BCAAs make a lot of sense, there's actually two of them. The first being if you consume a vegan diet. See, leucine is the primary amino acid responsible for building muscle, and most non-animal protein sources are very low in leucine. So if you took BCAAs with the leucine in it with your protein-containing meals as a vegan, you're going to help get that leucine up and help get the same response you would from an animal source. And this has actually been shown in research, which, by the way, I'll put all the different studies that I referenced in this video in the description below so you can check them out if you want. The other scenario where I think BCAAs make a lot of sense is if you like to train fasted, or if you just wake up early in the morning and you like to train, train but have a hard time getting food in first, you're gonna wanna get some BCAAs in first to help increase protein synthesis going in, and then you'll wanna get a good protein source in as soon as possible after your workout. And for what it's worth, I do think that BCAAs make more sense in a fat loss phase when your calories are low and you wanna do everything you can to keep your body from using muscle as fuel. Anyway, in general, no, you definitely don't need BCAAs, and you can get fantastic results without them. As long as your training's on point, your diet's on point, you're getting your protein in, that's gonna get you 98% of the way there anyway. Those are the big things. However, it's possible BCAAs could help just a little bit with results. If you wanna try to get a little bit more, if you wanna try to do everything you can to get the best possible results, they may help a little bit. Even if for no other reason, it can be kind of fun just to sip on something that tastes good during a workout. But to me, it basically just comes down to cost. If you don't mind spending extra money to get some potentially better results, then it makes sense. But if you don't have the extra money, or if you just don't wanna spend the money on something that isn't really proven, then you don't have to bother with it. It's not gonna be the major contributor to your results anyway. But if you wanna build as much muscle as possible and get the best results you can, then make sure you take this info and combine it with the info from this video about using meal timing to give you the best possible response in protein synthesis and make the most gains possible. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments below and I'll be sure to get back to you, and I will see you next time.